A huge issue when agents are working the phones is keeping someone on the phone from start, I don't know who you are, till the very end, thank you for your business, okay? Because what I've learned is, early in a call, people will say things like, I'm just looking, I'm just shopping, I already have coverage, I'm not interested, I don't want to talk, call me back, I'm busy, etc., right? And then originally they're like, I'm not buying anything today, I'm just looking. And then 60 minutes later, they're like, dude, thank you so much for selling me. Okay, so what's the psychology behind that? And how do we get you from point A to point B to help you keep them on the phone? So I'm gonna cover several things, a lot of things that I haven't necessarily covered before, specifically on how to keep someone's attention on the phone. People's attention spans are extremely short, right? I'm gonna fix that. Right now, one of the first thing I'm gonna talk to you about is how do you keep someone's actual attention on the phone? I don't care if you're PNC, life and health, Medicare, whatever, right? Doesn't matter, commercial, et cetera, home and auto. If you don't have someone's attention, you have my permission to ask them, I don't have your attention yet, do I? Because I believe in losing the sell on my own terms. I don't believe it's up to them. I believe everything about this thing is up to you and I. Okay, I got my prison polo on today. They let me out for a few hours. I go back and report back to prison tomorrow. But they're letting me shoot a little content in the meantime, all right? So, but when you think about this, and a lot of agents are in a mental prison, by the way. They're like, I want to quit. I'm struggling. I want to fail. I'm not making any money. I don't know what to do. And I was just coaching a guy, and most of the things that were going on for him was mindset. He was complaining about his upline and how people aren't answering the phone and a lot of other things, right? You control everything. It's your decision to make, no matter what happens along the way. If you want to keep someone's attention and own them during that call, you can. But you can't worry about losing the sell. If you do, you're going to lose it on your own terms, right? So it's okay to say stuff like, I don't have your attention yet, do I? How do I keep your attention? How do I get it? Can you turn the TV off because, you know, I'm having trouble hearing you? Can you do me that favor? Is that okay? Right? It's okay to say stuff like that. I would rather you talk like that and say stuff like that early in a call to keep someone's attention, because if you don't have their attention, you have zero chance of selling them. Also, if you can't keep them on the phone, you have zero chance of selling them. I've noticed that if I can just keep them on the phone, going through the motions, by the end of it, I got a really good shot of actually making a sale, right? The longer they stay on the call, the more my chances of actually getting a policy and closing goes up. Okay, so we talk about a lot of different things. Today, immediately, I wanna talk about a few things. I wanna talk about energy, I wanna talk about tonality, and I wanna talk about control, okay? If someone says, I'm not interested, right? What they're saying is, you're not interesting. Your energy level sucks. I don't like listening to you, right? Have you ever had the telemarketer call you and they're like, you know, extremely monotone, you know, hey, Jimmy, this is Cody. How are you doing today? You know, like there's no life in them. They're boring. They're freaking awful. You have to focus on your energy level the whole day. Most of us, we go out throughout our day and we lose energy level throughout the day. Like, right, we don't work out, energy level's down. We don't take a cold shower, energy level's down, right? We go out and eat, you know, freaking a whole piece of pizza or bar, you know, and before you know it, 2 o'clock comes and I don't have any energy anymore, right? Everything you do throughout your day will affect your energy level. Well, your energy level will affect every single call that you ever make. Okay, so your energy level has to be high. I don't care if you gotta fake it on every single call. It's gotta be there, right? When I get on video camera, I don't just stand up here and say, hey guys, I'm Cody Askins and maybe I hope that you'll learn something today and if you can, you'll make money. Right? You guys would freaking tune out and go watch somebody else's YouTube channel, right? That's the big reason why you watch, is because I try to be entertaining and actually bring some energy to this thing, because energy is everything. Think about the person other than the phone. If you're them, like when you listen to your own call recordings, if you're them, would you keep listening? Based on your energy level, based on the way you talk, based on the way you sound, right? Okay, huge, it's important. Tonality, your tonality is crucial because that's how you can, that's how there's some ups and downs, right? So when I do videos, right, I may get quiet to stress a point. I may even pause just to get someone's attention, right? I may tell a story to get your eyes back focused when I'm talking, right? Or I may go up when I really wanna get excited about something, okay? Stuff like that, specifically when you're talking to someone in person, can affect the overall tonality and energy. Your tonality can't be this the entire time that you're on the phone, right? That's the same. That's freaking boring. No one wants to listen to someone. Their tonality is like freaking, it's the graph or the line as if someone is not having any life left in their body. That's what that is, right? That's a tonality that you do not want to have, okay? Now, control. How do you keep control of the call, right? They're like, well, the best way is literally to, when they try to take control of the call, the best way, agree, I'm going to just call it pivot for today, and then ask. Like literally what that means is get back on script, right? I'm not interested. I understand, right? This is just an informational call. Now tell me, what got you thinking about all this, you know? Or you know what, I don't have any money. I'm with you. This program's actually meant for people that don't have a lot of money, you know? So what, let's jump right into your health, you know? Or hey, I'm running out of time, you know, I don't want to talk, you know? Totally get it, you know, I don't have a lot of time either. I promise this will be very brief, it's almost done. So tell me, right? And then pivot back. That's the key to keeping control of a call, is you gotta be really good at pivoting, right? You know, they have the pivot in basketball, you know, where if you move the other foot, oh, it's a walk, right? If you don't pivot, you're walking in the middle of the call, right? You need to be agreeable, right? You can't say stuff like, well, you know, well, you must have time, you answer the phone, you know, like, freak, I'm gonna hang up on you too, right? Agreeable, pivot, simple. They're trying to take you off the call and you're coming back, right? It's freaking simple, right? Pivot and ask. Most people forget to ask the question, right? To reassume control. And most people don't realize that all this stuff can be scripted, practice, role played, and you can simply get really good at doing this by simply pivoting back and forth. They say something stupid, you bring them back to reality, right back into the script, right? And ask a question. Extremely simple. I don't care what they say, majority of the time they're lying to you, okay? So that's how you can try to keep control, right? Because most people forget too that all this is a natural human conversation. This is a natural human conversation that you're having with someone. You don't want to sound like a robot. You don't want to sound scripted. Robots are monotone, right? Robots are extremely scripted, right? It's okay to have a script, but you need to make it your own so much, and you go through it so much, and you listen to recordings so much, and when they give you objections, you have the specific phrases that you're ready to say back, that it doesn't matter because you're having a natural human conversation with them. Okay. Now, when we're talking about a sales call, you need to keep them engaged early. Early. I don't care if you got to say something freaking crazy to keep them in the zone with you, but you have to keep them engaged early. The studies show that the best chance to lose them are the first 5 seconds, 30 seconds, and 60 seconds. Okay. You have to be really good during those three parts of the call. Betty. Hey, it's Cody. Right? That's it, right? That's the intro. We talk talking about intro. We've talked about the intro a bazillion times. That's the intro, right? It's simple, right? Hey, getting back to you. Hey, appreciate your response. You know what I'm talking about, right? If I ever need to like get their attention, or I'm losing them, or I'm talking too much, or the paragraph is too long, I may say something like, right? You're following me, right? You know I'm calling, right? You understand why I'm asking all these questions, right? You see what I'm saying? You remember this. It makes them respond to you. It also can put them on the defensive a little bit instead of the offensive, which is good. Because it's that's the best way. When you watch master freaking closers and salespeople, one of the best ways that they keep control is they'll ask something crazy they'll ask something the person doesn't know the answer to. Like, right? When someone's ever called out of an audience and the speaker asks them a question and they end up looking silly because they're like, I don't know what to freaking say, right? That's the same idea. It keeps that person in control and they're able to keep asking the questions, and guess what? They have no choice but to stay engaged because they're trying to like freaking focus here, okay? So think about that, right? If you're in the middle of something, you're like, man, I've been talking too much. Betty, you still with me? Okay, that's okay to ask. It's okay to say those things, all right? So, energy, tonality, control, okay? We also, You've got to get really good at this word. I look like John Madden on a whiteboard today, but that's all right. Okay, I'm doing it on purpose just to keep your attention because you can't even freaking read what I'm writing. Okay, ignore everything that they say. Maybe not what I say, but what they say to you early in a call, just flip and ignore it. Like, just throw it away, man. Who cares, right? I'm not interested. Amazing, right? I'm broke. Perfect. Can't health qualify? Incredible, right? Who freaking cares? Most of the stuff they're telling you is totally made up. This is a wild video, but the point is, right? I'm talking to you about how to keep the attention on a call, right? I'm showing you how to keep attention during a video at the same time, all right? So use this. Keep them engaged, man. Keep them engaged. You liked this, didn't you? Because you like this, I got another gold freaking video, 0 to 5 milli in under 5, okay? It's right there. Incredible video. Go watch that. I'm gonna jump over there and I'll see you there.
Again, back to zero. And then first year as kind of a broker, I did 110,000, so six figures.